Near-peer rivals of the US, like Russia and China, are investing in long-range anti-ship missiles. The idea is to hold key American assets like aircraft carriers and multi-purpose amphibious assault ships such as Wasp-class vehicles at risk. The US needs a high-endurance, fixed-wing platform that can provide long-range surveillance as well as attack capability. General Atomics Aeronautical Systems, Inc., GA-ASI, is working on an innovative solution for this situation. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how STOL version MQ9B Reaper will change the way US forces engage rivals in future conflicts. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play online military-themed strategy game Conflict of Nations, which is played by millions of players worldwide. We talk a lot about military power and tactical plans of different nations on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? Conflict of Nations is set in the late 20th and early 21st century, fielding present-day and highly modern battlefield technology. At the core of the game is an exciting real-time combat system, placing players in control of an existing nation of this world and its army, pitting them against other gamers in a struggle for world domination. Units are moved across the map in real time, often taking hours to fulfill their assigned mission goals, allowing for a very deep level of strategic planning and integrated tactical execution. Forming lasting alliances or short-lived coalitions is an essential part of the modern military environment. Hence, Conflict of Nations allows players to form cooperative clans and teams in an all-out effort to conquer set objectives through the combined force of arms. Conflict of Nations can be played in PC or mobile. So why wait? Register yourself using the link in the description below and get 13,000 gold reward along with 1 month Security Council membership. General Atomics announced that they were developing the STOL, or Short Takeoff and Landing, Reaper, on May 10th. GA-ASI President David Alexander said, "Imagine taking the hard top off your Jeep. You lift it off, stow it in your garage, and now you've got an open vehicle. If it rains, you put the hard top back on. We're the same. Take a standard MQ-9B, put the STOL kit on, and then go fly." They also published an animated video of a Marine Corps marked MQ-9 taking off from the deck of what appears to be the USS Macon Island, or LHD-8, judging by the number painted on the island. The MQ-9 then lands and folds its wings. Alexander said in a statement on GA-ASI's website, "STOL means we can take this incredibly capable, long-endurance aircraft and get into and out of more airfields and more places. If you need to have these aircraft switch up where they're operating, either because you don't have a long, conventional airfield, or because you don't want an adversary to know where one might land after a mission, you have numerous options about where you can operate." The company said it is taking on this revolutionary engineering effort to meet an evolving operational environment in contested expeditionary environments. Alexander added, "Picture something like an amphibious assault ship, such as the USS America. Our wing set folds up so that MQ-9B STOL could park on the deck or in the hangar bay, just like any other naval aircraft. When it's time to launch, you start up the aircraft, unfold the wings, and take off over the bow just like any other aircraft, without the need for ship launch aids. No catapult needed." Alexander stated, "By extending the surveillance umbrella of the amphibious ships, we can also host kinetic capabilities that would act as a first line of defense for Navy ships. They don't have anything like this right now, so you could use it to support your forces in the littoral, on the beach, or blue water operations." The General Atomics MQ-9 Reaper, sometimes called Predator B, is an unmanned aerial vehicle, or UAV, capable of remotely controlled or autonomous flight operations developed by General Atomics Aeronautical Systems, primarily for the United States Air Force. The MQ-9 is the first hunter-killer UAV designed for long-endurance, high-altitude surveillance. It's a larger, heavier, and more capable aircraft than Predator, which ushered in the drone age. Reaper has an endurance of 27 hours, a service ceiling of 50,000 feet, a range of 1,151 miles, or 1,852 kilometers, and a max speed of 300 miles per hour, or 482 kilometers per hour. With the ER, or Extended Range Kit, Reapers will have an endurance of up to 42 hours without external stores. Reaper's main sensor is the nose-mounted MTS-B multi-spectral surveillance and targeting turret and its fuselage-mounted Lynx synthetic aperture radar. But Reaper's pylons are very versatile and can be used to carry a variety of tactical equipment like communications relay hops, electronic warfare pods, as well as wide area aerial surveillance (WAAS) camera arrays. The additional sensors are designed to act in conjunction with the drone's main sensors. The USAF is also planning to put more potent radars on board some Reapers. The idea is to create ground-moving targeting identification (GMTI) sensor nodes that can be dispersed around the war zone. GMTI is a radar capability that can be used to trail moving targets on the ground over time using radar. Reaper has the ability to carry around 2,500 pounds or 1,100 kilograms of weapons payload through its external hardpoints. The Reaper's hardpoints give it the ability to deploy a combination of AGM-114 Hellfire, GBU-12 Paveway, and GBU-38 JDAM munitions. Apart from these air-to-ground weapons, Reaper could potentially be armed with AIM-9X air-to-air missile. Reaper can also be employed as a sub-hunter, as it's capable of carrying and deploying sonobuoys from a wing-mounted pneumatic launching pad. Reaper is an effective wide-area surveillance platform. It can extend the eyes of a ship over large areas of the ocean for long periods of time. The drone could be extremely useful in many scenarios. For example, it can be used to identify anti-ship batteries of the Chinese DF-21D missile, which is said to be the world's first anti-ship ballistic missile (ASBM). This info could then be used to destroy these threats with preemptive strikes. Similarly, Reaper could be used against submarines. It would be able to detect and relay the information gathered by the sonobuoys back to the warships or to manned submarine hunting helicopters. Given the overall capabilities, there's no doubt it would be a major force multiplier and change the way American forces fight future wars.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.